Hello and welcome to latest TV entertainment news. I'm Andrew Kay and here are my top tips to keep you entertained over the coming weeks. From the moment I heard the song I Got You Babe, despite the bad grammar, I've been fascinated by Cher. The iconic pop warbler has undergone so many incarnations that she seems to be immortal. Now her career, spanning six decades and heading into a seventh, is celebrated in the Cher Show. Let's take a look and a listen. Vision beautifully realised in this full-on sequin and spandex bedecked production directed by Arlene Philips and choreographed by Otis Mabuse, and it stars Debbie Kurup, Danielle Steers and Millie O'Connell, and is coming to Theatre Royal Brighton for 2 weeks from Tuesday the 1st of November. The word once was that the Germans had no sense of humour, but Henning Wehn is the proof that this is just not true. I foresaw Henning in a small room above a pub one Christmas and I laughed all the way to New Year. Now Henning Wehn's new show, It'll All Come Out in the Wash, is coming to Brighton Dome. Let's see him in action talking British politics.
Bad for now, here's German comedy ambassador Henning Wehn to tell us what's wrong with British politics.
Yes, thank you very much, Jeremy. Well, feels slightly bizarre that I'm being given the opportunity to comment on the general election on national TV when I wasn't even allowed to actually vote in it, always being a foreigner and all that. So, at least guarantees a degree of impartiality, I suppose. Actually, quite pleased I wasn't allowed, as haven't got a team, so to speak. If I had to pick one, I would have gone for UKIP. At least they're serious about implementing Otto von Bismarck's 19th century plan of isolating Britain. Anyway, Jeremy, to answer your question, what's wrong with British politics? Well, first and foremost, the constant talk of fairness. During the election campaign, all parties have been going on about their version of what constitutes a fairer society. But not a single one of them suggested the most obvious step towards a fairer society. Abolish the monarchy. And that reaction is exactly why no one suggested it. Let's quickly move on. What else is wrong with British politics? Well, the treatment of MPs. Why anyone would want to become a member of parliament is totally beyond me. It is the impossible job. They get stick no matter what. Even someone as dislikable as George Osborne, and he does come across a fairly dislikable fella, even he is given a totally unfair deal. He's a robot, he's a people destroyer, he has got no emotion. Then, at the Thatcher funeral, his eyes went ever so slightly moist, and the whole country united and was up in arms. Look at that emotional wreck, he's not fit to run the country. He's always in London. Why is he always in London? Well, last week he was in Wolverhampton. What the fuck's he doing in Wolverhampton? Why was he in London? Who would want to do that job? And tell you what else is wrong with British politics. It's too slow. It's gone midnight and we're still waiting for the final results. This, to me, is the ultimate mystery of UK election night. Why does it take them so long to declare? Now, if I'd run a council, I would go, look, we're on telly tonight. The whole country is watching. Today, just today, let's pretend we work in the private sector. uh-huh. and put in a decent shift, then tomorrow back to normal. Well, there is a few places where being quick actually is part of civic pride. As the Sunderland Echo put it in a run-up to the last general election, hopes are now... my Geordie accent isn't quite there yet. hopes are now high that Sunderland's three constituencies will be the first to declare, putting Wearside firmly on the map and making the city an international talking point. Well, one can almost picture two tribesmen in the Mali desert. Have you heard about Sunderland declaring within the hour? Of course I have. What are you doing with that camel dung? In a nutshell, abolish the monarchy, show MP some respect and get on with that counting. People want to go bad.
So, sit down, you ludicrous Teuton. how exactly is going to... abolishing the monarchy going to make politics better in this country?
Well, I don't want to sound like a 14-year-old girl, but it's just not
fair,
is it?
You really don't.
Thank you very much. That puts me at ease. Well, it's just not fair, is it? Like, when you always go on about upward social... I mean, that's the point of it.
It is the point of it, yes.
Well, I was always... I mean, usually they say the good thing about the monarchy is it gives emotional stability. Well, but the memories of 45 and 66 do exactly the same job. and it's free. So, yeah, no, I don't think you can go on about upward social mobility and fulfil your potential and all that whilst at the same time there is a monarchy.
Well, here's the problem with getting rid of the monarchy. If you get rid of the monarchy, we have to have a new constitution. And the people who would invent a new constitution would be our current politicians. And our current politicians are loathsome. So...
call me naive, but I think most politicians are actually in it to serve society. I don't think there is many people that join a political party at grassroots level, give up their evenings and weekends so that one day in the future they might be able to wrongly claim for a second Hoover. I think they have gone their local community at heart.
I agree with you, and I don't really think they're loathsome. I think they're a disappointing crop, and I think one of the reasons they're a disappointing crop... It's like we're going to eat them. But, you know, one of the reasons I think they're disappointing is exactly one of the points you made, which is we treat them like shit, we have a go at them, whatever. If they seem too human, we go, oh, what's that human thing? You're not perfect. And if they seem perfect, we go, you're too perfect, be human. So we're very unfair on them, and we pay them like crap, and as a result, we're not...
£67,000 a year? Well, numerous allowances and allowances and allowances and allowances.
Well, for the whole country to go, oh, look, he doesn't know how to eat a bacon sandwich.
There are better paid ways of looking like a dick. For example, being a comedian. But as a result, I think you've got people who are very earnest about politics, and you've got people who might as well have a go at it because they don't, they've got inherited wealth and, you know, they'll do all right that way. But I don't think you're attracting the widest possible range of interesting, dynamic, capable people into politics at the moment, which is why now is not the time to change constitutions and have the ones we've got at the moment think up a new way of having a president or something instead of the Queen.
Do you want to suggest how we could improve our counting of the votes as well?
Well, just put a bit of effort in, I reckon. because it's so straightforward, isn't it?
Standing there quite happily taking the piss out of Sunderland. Sunderland actually got the first three results declared this time.
Of course,
too.
And I can declare for them for the next general election right now. If you want me to.
That's quite true. You can predict they'll elect a Labour MP each time, yes.
Well, the thing is, if the constituency election isn't at all close, you don't have to count very carefully. You just make two piles and you go, well, that's obviously bigger.
Yeah, but now on a practical level. So how long, say, you have got four or five different boxes there for the different parties and you stand there with a pile of ballot papers. How long does it take you to put per sheet, one sheet, into the relevant box? How much will it take you?
I don't know, you're asking us to do a time and motion study.
So essentially you have got something like
this. Boring job.
Yeah. You have something like this, put it down. Say
a
second.
About a second and a half or something, yeah.
Yeah, so a second and a half would be 40 a minute, would be 2,400 in an hour. So essentially they should be able to declare within 5 to 10 minutes.
My God, I see why you make cars so well.
What do you think British politics could learn from Germany, then, apart from time and motion studies?
See yourself as part of Europe, for starters. Like that whole debate if Britain is in Europe or not. Well, get a map. The answer is that. And... yeah, well, it's interesting, isn't it, when you see, like, David Cameron, essentially the difference, say, between Merkel and Cameron at the moment seems to be that Merkel steers her party more and more to the middle ground, whilst with the Conservatives there is the problem that potentially they get drawn more and more to the right, so probably just be a stronger leader.
Can you see any other obvious difference between Angela Merkel and David Cameron?
What, are you talking about gender?
Shouldn't be an issue, it's 2015. Sexist.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, moving on, people say television is becoming too self-referential.
Well, you can catch German comedy ambassador Henning Wehn giving everything a good rinse and witnessing wring sense out of the nonsensical. Henning Wehn, It's All Come Out in the Wash, is in Brighton Dome Concert Hall on Saturday the 1st of October. That's all tonight, but catch me again tomorrow for more top tips from the world of art and entertainment. Good night.